If you're wondering how to make the best of your camera on the Honor 70, we've prepared a list of 10 tips and tricks that'll help you take your photography game to the next level. This is Sandeep from Rev Atlas, let's get this started. Number 1 is composition of framing. This is one aspect of photography that may seem simple, but also one that makes a lot of difference. It's not necessary to place your object or subject always in the center of the frame. While keeping them in the center works at times, mostly offsetting your object or subject to one side will make for a more compelling and visually appealing frame. You can make use of assistive grids option on the Honor 70 to help you compose your shot better, and there are 4 different modes to choose from. Reading up a bit on different compositions such as rule of thirds will help too. Number 2 is making refinements. Although smartphones such as the Honor 70 are great these days at choosing the point of focus and metering well, it's always best to choose the point of focus by clicking on it to ensure that it is in focus, and then also making slight adjustments if needed to the image using the brightness slider before taking the shot. You can choose to make it brighter or darker based on your needs. Number 3 is make use of the HDR mode. Smartphones these days have good dynamic range by default. However, something that helps it even further is the HDR mode that combines multiple photos into one to prevent overexposed highlights or underexposed shadows. When you're in situations with a lot of bright and dark areas in one single frame, it's often best to use this to create a more appealing and dramatic image. Number 4 is use Beautify when necessary. The Beautify feature is great to make people look good even on days when they don't look their best. However, it does tend to soften things if left on, so especially when you're shooting landscapes, architecture, and any situation where there aren't people involved, it's best to turn the feature off to get the best sharpness possible. Number 5 is wide aperture mode. The Honor 7A has dual cameras at the back, one of which is a depth sensing camera that helps to get depth information from the scene you're shooting. You can enable the wide aperture mode to make use of this to your advantage. You just need to choose your point of focus and adjust the level of blur to match the output needed. This helps isolate the object or subject you're shooting and gives you a bokeh and blur that's similar to what you would get from professional cameras. But the best part of all this is the ability to refocus after you've taken the photo and even adjust the blur levels. Number 6 is choose the highest resolution. The Honor 7A shoots up to 13 megapixels in terms of resolution for photos. That's quite a lot of information, and it allows you to crop into the frame to get closer to a subject or object in case you weren't physically able to do so, and also allows you to reframe the image later if you want to. Number 7 is don't zoom in. While zooming into a scene and taking a photo may give you the immediate desired output, it's always better to take the full frame and then crop into it later to get the desired output. This way you'll be able to use whatever portion of the frame you want and won't regret not having captured the entire scene either. Number 8 is improving stability. A more stable smartphone will result in a better looking and shake-free photo. So it's always advisable to rest your Honor 70 on a bench, a book, a table, a rock, or even a tripod if you have one handy. Number 9 is post-processing. While many people frown when they hear the term, there's nothing wrong with processing your photos after capturing them. In fact, it even makes them more appealing. Even if you cook food that's extremely delicious, without proper plating, it doesn't look appetizing. So make a few changes to the photo after it's captured, and that can really go a long way in changing the impact. The Honor 70 has quite a capable photo editor, which even has a splash feature that allows selective coloring. Number 10 and the last one is keep your lens clean. This may seem like something you know already, but many people take their lenses for granted. While a small smudge may not cause much drop in quality, other stuff such as dirt, oil, food particles, etc. will definitely affect the outcome, and the result will be less than its full potential. It's always recommended to wipe your camera lens with a microfiber cloth or one of the softer cloths that you may find. That's it for this video, guys. This video is brought to you by Honor. Thanks for watching this video. See you again in the next one.